the Subcommittee on Communications and Technology for our legislative hearing on FCC reauthorization, improving commission transparency. I want to welcome our witnesses today. Appreciate your being here. Our subcommittee, often on a bipartisan basis, has worked to make the Federal Communications Commission a more transparent and accountable public policy for many years and under various FCC chairmen. These bills, sponsored by my colleagues, continue those well-meaning efforts to make even powerful bureaucrats realize that this is the public's business that's being conducted. The FCC is not some venture capital firm. The FCC is an independent agency that reports to Congress. Commissioner O'Reilly, thank you for your well-reasoned and helpful testimony. I appreciate your insights, tone, and suggestions. You seem to understand the proper role of the FCC and welcome the opportunity to improve how it functions so that it can better serve the public. I commend you for your views and your willingness to work with this subcommittee. You've pointed out material problems at the FCC, and you've offered constructive solutions, and I thank you for that. Now, I wish I could say the same thing about Chairman Wheeler's testimony. If you really think that drafting, amending, and adopting rules without giving the public more opportunity to see them before they're crammed down their throats is good process, then maybe it's no wonder the public has little faith in the agencies of government. Under the current power structure at the FCC, the chairman has incredible authority that none of the other commissioners has, because the chairman alone controls access to FCC information. He or she can call in their own validators to get the inside track and become a well-tuned chorus of support for their pet policies. Friends of the chairman get special perks to weigh in and access information that the rest of the public just doesn't get to see, and that other commissioners can't even discuss. Commissioner O'Reilly exposes this charade for what it is in his testimony. None of us on this committee would tolerate that insult to our First Amendment rights that the commissioners at the FCC must suffer at the hands of a chairman. Chairman Wheeler urges us to not make the FCC subject to its own special set of rules. This is a refrain I've heard from some of my colleagues who want to expand the commission's private discussions, a special rule that would only apply to the FCC, but oppose making the commission's actions more public. If the chairman would like to subject the FCC to the same rules as the other agencies of the federal government, why, we can certainly make that happen. Of course, that would mean the chairman could no longer handpick the agency's inspector general or have the IG report to the chairman. We'd have real independence in the IG's office. And under the rules that other agencies follow, we wouldn't have this silly argument over producing cost-benefit analyses for rulemakings. The FCC would simply have to follow the law and produce them, like other agencies. Trying to hide behind the skirt of the APA and then pretend the FCC is just another federal agency actually insults this committee. And I cannot help but respond to the nonsense that my colleague's legislation would somehow unduly burden the FCC by requiring it to link a document that already exists to its website. Such a requirement wasn't considered a burden when the FCC forced broadcasters to scan their political files and make them available on the internet. But now we're supposed to believe that a similar requirement for an agency with 1,700 employees is just too much of a burden. Really? The FCC loves to come up to Capitol Hill and tell us how they're special because they have a public interest mandate. That mandate is a double-edged sword, which means you're stuck with both the rights and the attendant obligations. So I can't for the life of me come up with legitimate rationale for how it's in the public interest to operate in secret, specifically excluding the public from the rules you're considering. My colleagues who wrote these measures and I are on the side of reforming the Washington bureaucracy. It's disappointing to see that you don't share our commitment to better government. We believe the public deserves more access to the process. We believe the public's best served by an open, transparent, and accountable government, and we will not stop in our cause and quest, even if that means taking on the entrenched and powerful. We have only just begun. I yield the remainder of my time to the Vice Chair of the Subcommittee, Mr. Latta, for any comments he'd like to make.
Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you for holding today's hearing. As the subcommittee continues to examine the reauthorization of the FCC, I remain firm in my belief that given the Commission's